Oh, hello there. I'm Nick. I'm here for a monthly checkup. You see, I have asthma, and today I'm going to tell you all I know about my condition. After all, who better to tell you than a patient what's wrong with them, right? Anyway, before we go ahead, click subscribe and ring the notification bell so that you don't miss our new videos. Oh, and while you're at it, watch till the end of the video to help support your very own bestie. Let's start with the basics. Think of your lungs as an exhaustion pipe of an engine. If the exhaustion pipe is fine, then the engine will be fine. If there's carbon or some other particle stuck in the exhaustion pipe, then it'll affect the engine. This is the same case with the airways of your lungs, which help inhale and exhale air. When these airways have become swollen or inflamed, it becomes difficult for the air to move as freely. And this is what's known as asthma. The problem with this disease is that it's chronic and there are no known ways to cure it. The airways can become extremely sensitive, and if you have this problem, you may find it difficult to breathe. In some cases, it might also have a cough along with asthma, especially if you don't have it under control. Of course, there are ways to control it, and although there is no cure, it can be prevented. To do that, let's first understand some of its symptoms. One of the most common one being shortness of breath. You feel shortness of breath because the swelling makes it harder for you to breathe and your chest feels tight. This is also the part where the coughing issue starts. As people find it harder to breathe and the more pressure they exert, the more stress they put on their lungs. In some cases, people might cough for no reason at night or feel breathless while they're trying to sleep. Ever found it hard to breathe after a session at the gym? This might be why. This brings us to our next symptom, wheezing. Some people make a whistling-like sound when they're breathing, while others might find it hard to breathe through their nose. This symptom affects people in different ways. The bottom line is that the mucus gets stuck in the airways between your lungs and your nose, causing a wheezing sound every time you breathe. It's usually one of the first symptoms to most breathing problems. Speaking of which, the last symptom is cold. Generally, a common cold doesn't last for more than 2 to 3 days. In some cases, though, it lingers for more than a week or even 10 days. It causes the mucus to go into the chest, making it harder for a person to breathe. So if you happen to have a cold that's been around for about 8 to 10 days or more, I would suggest visiting a doctor. Now that we know some symptoms of this problem, how common is asthma and when can we be affected by it? 1 in 13 people may have asthma, and it can happen at any age. Yes, folks, you can get this disease at any age. While it's more common in children, at times it can also be seen occurring in adulthood. At times, it may remain dormant and the person may not have any breathing problems. A child with asthma may not have issues with it while growing up, but then it would show up again later in life. Look at me, for example. I thought I had outgrown asthma as a child after I didn't get any asthma symptoms for years. Yet, it's come back to affect me now, and I can tell you it's not a good feeling. For many people, asthma may happen in the middle of adulthood. There are many reasons, starting from smoking, pollution, and even a bad cold or flu. Some people may have it because of professional or personal stress. All of these things can lead to asthma, and once you have it, you may have to bear with it for a lifetime. So what happens when you have asthma? Well, a lot of things, and one of the most deadly is an asthma attack. An asthma attack can either be severe or mild, and sometimes it can be life-threatening. The worst part is, anyone who has this problem may have an asthma attack. Some people have been reported to experience a mild attack followed by more severe ones. During an asthma attack, mucus fills the airway and the muscles tighten up. It makes the airway narrower and the person who is having this problem finds it harder and harder to breathe. This is why it's important that you know what to do when you're having an asthma attack. First step would be to try to stay as calm as possible. I know, it's easier said than done, but trust me, if there's anyone who can do it, it's you. If you panic, the pressure in your lungs will increase, and that'll make the attack worse for you. So the mantra is to remain calm in any way possible. The next step would to be look for help. If you can, find someone you know. If you can't, find anyone, and then just try finding a place to sit. If you've not been diagnosed with asthma and this is the first time you're having an attack, then call the doctor right away. In case you've already been diagnosed, try the quick relief medication that's been given to you by your doctor. Now, what if the medication doesn't work? Well, in this case, you can do two things. If you can still move around, get to the doctor as soon as possible. If you're not in a state to do so, then call an emergency helpline service. Oh, and I would suggest that you avoid adjusting your medication plan, unless your doctor suggests so. It's important that you get the proper medication for the disease. You might think that skipping a dosage may not be as harmful as the doctor says, but take it from me, it can be very dangerous. On the bright side, taking proper medication for asthma will allow you to stay active and perform all your day-to-day tasks without any severe or mild attacks. You won't have to deal with the issues, such as shortness of breath or a tight feeling around your lungs. It'll also drastically reduce the mucus. Your lungs' functions will be back to normal, and if the medication is taken properly, then there's not supposed to be any major side effects. Although, we would suggest that you brief your doctor about your entire medical history, just to be safe. Yes. Asthma is a dangerous problem and it can be fatal, but don't give up on life. Yes, it's going to be tough at first, but it'll get better over time. Patience is a virtue and you'll need to practice this in this scenario. Oh, it looks like it's time for me to go to meet my doctor. Hey, let me tell you a little secret. Just like you, I don't really like doctors. Unfortunately, I still have to deal with them because of this problem. So, do you have asthma? How has it affected your life? Let us know in the comment section below. We would love to hear from you. Enjoyed this video? Hit like, share, and subscribe to Bestie. Wait, what kind of bestie would we be if we didn't tell you about our other awesome videos? Go ahead, choose the left or right video and enjoy.